Dear Honorable President Faisal Al-Fayyaz, President of Jordan of Senate, and thank you very much for joining us today. We really appreciate your contribution to the conference. In the conference, I'm Ahmed Masih Atmar from Afghanistan with my colleagues, Ms. Anastasia Al-Ayoubi from Lebanon. We have a couple of questions for you. We will start with Ms. Anastasia.
Okay, so I wanted to ask you, we're talking about a two-state solution for Israel. So basically my question is, like, will the other countries of the Middle East accept this idea? Will Palestine agree on this? And will Israel stop its policy of expansion?
Of course, there was an Arab initiative by King Abdullah, the late King Abdullah bin Abdul Aziz, who has said clearly that if a peace agreement will be reached between Israel and the Palestinians, then all the Arab and Islamic countries will recognize Israel. So this is very clear. As for the countries who are working towards peace, of course, all the Arab countries are working towards peace, but unfortunately, the Israelis, they don't want peace because all the policies of the present Israeli government, especially the Prime Minister Netanyahu, he is only putting obstacles against achieving peace. So the main problem is Israel and not the Arab world. If Israel will accept a two-state solution, a sovereign Palestinian state within the 1967 border, then I think the Arab world will reach an agreement with Israel and even the Islamic states, as has been stated by the late King Abdullah bin Abdul Aziz.
There are a possibility that there might be a domestic instability in Jordan. If yes, then how the Hashemite Kingdom will deal with it, and how it will affect the relations between U.S. and Jordan?
No, I don't. Jordan is a stable and secure country. I don't think we have a problem. Of course, we are under threat from terrorist groups. But until now, if you compare Jordan to other Arab countries like Syria, like Iraq, Jordan is very stable. We have a strong army who can defend our borders. We have strong security organizations who can protect Jordan internally. Our economy, although it's not doing very well at the moment, but we still have a 2.5% economic growth every year, which is compared to other countries is very good, and taking into consideration what's going on, the instability in the region. So I assure you that Jordan will stay secure, I hope, with the effort of His Majesty, our armed forces, and our people who believe in our king, that he can always lead us to what's better for Jordan.
Inshallah.
Thank you very much.
My second question is, how is Jordan dealing with the rise of refugees, especially since the rise of refugees? It has Palestinians and now it has Syrians. Like, is there enough resources? What about unemployment? How will it affect the economy development?
Of course, it is affecting our economy because, unfortunately, the international community, they are not shouldering their responsibilities. And we have a budget deficit now due to, because the government is spending on sustaining these refugees. And the international community is not giving much, but we hope that in the future the international community will shoulder their responsibilities. They will support Jordan. And as I have said in my speech, Jordan economically is going forward. But we need help. We need help from the European Union, from the United States, from other countries. But the main problem is economical in Jordan. It's not political. So I hope that there was the London conference, which was held some weeks ago. The international community has promised to give more aid, to invest more in Jordan, so that they will create more job opportunities. And this is what we are hoping for.
And our last question is, how do you see the future of Jordan and the region?
The future of Jordan, I hope it will be secure. But the future of the region, I think, you know, it's very difficult. Because even if we are optimistic, I think if you want to solve the problems facing the Arab world, especially in Syria, Iraq, Libya, I think it will take a long time. And I cannot see a light at the end of the tunnel, unfortunately. But we hope that there will be solutions for the problems facing the Arab countries.
Dear Honorable President, thank you very much for being here with us. We really are fortunate to have you here. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Thank you.